What if I told you that after this video, you're gonna be downloading Quack games to your Steam Deck straight from Steam? Hey guys, I'm JD Ross, and today I'm going to teach you how to install Steamtools on your Steam Deck. First, we have to install Port Proton. You can find it on the Discover store. Just search for Port Proton, and then install it. Okay, it's done installing. Let's try to run it. Now, if you're somehow stuck here, you can actually just run Port Proton again and it will run. But if this won't go away, you can use the system monitor to close it. This does not usually happen, but for some reason it happened right now when I'm trying to make the video. So yeah, let's try that to see if it goes away. It does. So let's try again. There we go. Right. So we have to install Steam first. Should be here under auto installs. There we go. So you have three options when adding shortcuts for any apps or games that you want to run through Port Proton. I believe menu and game would be here, right? And then desktop is this desktop, and Steam library is the one that you see on gaming mode. For Steam, in my experience, Steam Port Proton does not work properly on gaming mode and you won't be able to use it. I recommend only using Steam Port Proton in desktop mode. That's why it's unchecked. So, create shortcut, and there's the shortcut. Let's just leave this as default and then launch it. If a minute has passed and nothing happens, just open this up, launch it. There we go. So this is what you want to see, Steam downloading the update. Okay, so this should appear. All right, you're gonna have to log in your Steam account, and I'm going to show you this first. On the bottom, you see that Port Proton is running. If you right click on it, you have a file manager, which lets you browse the files that you have for Port Proton. There's Task Manager. It works just like the one on Windows. There's changelog if you want to see what's up with the new update. And there's Force Quit or Force Exit. That exits everything that's running under Port Proton, right? So let's log into Steam. Now that Steam is running, we have to change something on the settings. But first, let's add a folder somewhere. You can do this anywhere, but I'm going to add this on my games folder. I'm going to add a folder here named Port Proton. Every Steam game that we're going to install through Port Proton will go here, okay? So let's go to Steam, go to Settings, Storage, and then add a drive. Select, choose a location, this one, add, my computer, H. Now, it might be different on your Steam Deck, but in my case, it's always gonna be H. Games and Port Proton. Here we go. Select the new drive and make default. So now every game that's going to be installed on the Steam Deck through the Steam from Port Proton will be installed here. We're going to install Stardew Valley. I'm not really interested in that kind of game, but for the sake of testing, I'm going to test it using that game. Now, if you're wondering what type of game you can use this with, basically every game on Steam, except games with third-party launchers, such as GTA 5 or Red Dead Redemption, because I believe those use DRM from Rockstar Games, since they also use Rockstar Games Launcher. But also, you can't use this with games with de novo. You can download them, but you won't be able to play them. It also doesn't work with games that's only online mode. Well, you could sort of make it work by downloading the game and then installing a mod from Online Fix Me, but I'm not going to tackle that in this video. So let's search for Stardew Valley. Right. So as you see, I don't own the game. Okay. You have to take note of the app ID. It's 413150. Okay. We're going to get back to that in a minute. Let's open depotbox.org. Now, there are other websites to do this, but for this video, we're going to use this instead. You have to verify that you are human. We're going to type 413150. 413, okay. 3150. Search. Now, you have to verify again, I believe. Click here. Download game data. I'm going to save the file on my desktop. And we're going to set up Steamtools. You have to go to steamtools.net. Select that. Now, don't get intimidated. This website is going to be Chinese. Click the blue button and then download installable version. And we're going to save that on the... I'm going to save this on my SSD games. And then save. After downloading the files for the game and Steamtools, we're going to have to install Steamtools. Open it with Port Proton. Okay. Create a shortcut. I'm going to name it Steamtools. Add it to desktop. Create a shortcut. And launch it. Now, every time you run this, you have to run it using the setup exe. Don't run it with the installed version of the Steamtools. Okay, install, run. So we have Steamtools. Now right click on it and make sure that activate unlock mode and always stay unlocked is checked. Right click on Stardew Valley or whatever game you have. Extract it. Extract here. Open the folder. Select all the files and then drag it to the tiny little icon. It should say something like this. Okay. Now you can close Steamtools. If you see this window, don't create a shortcut. It's going to create a shortcut for the actual Steamtools.exe. And just like I mentioned before, you have to run the setup every time for the Steam Deck for it to work. So now we can run Steam. Launch it. Go to library, and your new game should be here. Stardew Valley. So as you see, I have the install button, but if we go to store, I still don't own the game. Okay? So let's install the game. Drive H. Install. So now the game is installed. We can now run it and see if it works. Okay, the game works. Let's close Steam for now. We're going to find the game. Should be on Port Proton, Steam Apps, Come On, and Stardew Valley. Let's open this with Port Proton. By the way, I believe you can change this to just choose Port Proton instead of whatever app. I'm going to move this up, apply. Okay, and now every time you try to open an exe, it's going to open with Port Proton instead. Double click. There we go. I can now run the game, but if for some reason your game does not run, you might have to try something else. Before playing the game, we're going to have a little tour in Port Proton. Here you have auto installs. Okay. You have emulators. I'm sure you know what that is. You have Wine settings. You can uninstall apps through here. It should look like this. Okay, type on Windows. Now, where did it go? I'm going to close Port Proton because, oh, there we go. Right. You have Wine Tricks. On Wine Tricks, you can use this to install dependencies or for games that actually need the dependencies. But in case of this video, you don't actually have to use this. I'm just going to show you. Right, so this is where dependencies are installed. You don't actually need to use this because the games will come from Steam and Steam will install the required stuff that's needed to run the game. We have Prefix Manager. This is basically just the Wine configuration. And you can set this to Windows 11 if you want for better compatibility on your games. File Manager. It's a file manager. and regedit and command line. We're not gonna get into them. Right, so let's get into Stardew Valley. I'm sure you've been waiting for that. You probably skipped to this part. Create a shortcut. And I'm gonna add it to games and the desktop and the Steam library. There we go. You have an option to change your wine. The reason I gave you a little tour on Port Porton is because you might have to download other wines. And here you have every wine version that you can download. Okay. I usually just use the latest G Proton. But of course, you can try the default first before tweaking the wine version. So the game is now on gaming mode, and we're gonna have to switch there to test out. Okay, we're now in gaming mode. If you can't find the game, it should be on library and it's gonna go to non-Steam because it is a non-Steam. Well, if it is from Steam, but not the official one, so it's gonna be a non-Steam. If you go to properties, it's gonna look like this. It's different from what you're probably used to how Quack games look on a Steam Deck. It's not using compatibility because it's running through Port Proton. So yeah, let's run the game. And we're done. That's how you install Steamtools on a Steam Deck. And if you want more videos like this, consider subscribing. And thank you for watching.